The goal of this video is to solve one second order differential equation. We would like to find the function y satisfying y double prime plus 4y equals cosine of 2t with some initial conditions. We're going to dedicate a whole video to just this example, because if you start to solve it using traditional techniques, you'll notice that resonance is happening. So in particular, if you take that left-hand side, y double prime plus 4y, and write down its associated characteristic or auxiliary equation, r squared plus 4, and solve for r values that set r squared plus 4 and make it 0, then you would get that r is plus or minus 2i, and so your homogeneous solution is a linear combination of cosine of 2t and sine of 2t. Okay, I just said all of that out loud, but it's what happens when we start trying to solve this differential equation. Our forcing function, cosine of 2t on the right-hand side, is reinforcing the natural harmonic motion of the solution to y double prime plus 4y equals 0. Again, that's a lot out loud. The point is that resonance is happening. So let's see what we would encounter when we start taking the Laplace transform of such a differential equation in this situation. Now, I want to say here that this is one of the nice things about the Laplace transform is that you don't have to do any of the analysis I just did out loud. So you don't have to start by knowing that resonance is happening. If you wanted to solve this differential equation with the Laplace transform, you just take the Laplace transform of both sides and proceed. The thing is, because resonance is happening in the background, whether you realize it or not, you are going to end up encountering expressions that we haven't looked at before. Okay, so let's get going with the actual material for this video. We would like to start by taking the Laplace transform of t times the complex exponential e to the I omega t. Why? We'll see when we actually solve this. But let's just start with this as kind of a warm-up exercise. We have only ever taken the Laplace transform of one type of product, and it's the type of product that we're looking at here, a function, in this case t, times an exponential. In the previous video, we called this type of exponential e to the at, and what it produced was a translation in s relative to the Laplace transform of just plain old t. So here, a is I omega. And we can immediately say that the Laplace transform of t times e to the I omega t is going to be the Laplace transform of t, but shifted. Okay, so first of all, what was the Laplace transform of t? It was 1 over s squared. Probably have that on a chart somewhere. So I've got to take s and subtract off of it I omega. Okay, so that is the translation in S when we take T and scale it by this exponential. We're not done. As usual, we're going to expand that denominator and then multiply by the complex conjugate in order to make it the denominator real. And from that, we'll be able to get to some pretty neat conclusions. Let me keep working a little bit to the right so that I don't run out of room. If I expand this, it looks like S squared minus 2is omega plus I squared omega squared, so that's actually minus omega squared, like that. The S squared and the omega squared are the real components. Then we have this imaginary component in the middle. We are going to take this, I'll do it below, but let me say what we're gonna multiply it by. Top and bottom are going to get multiplied by the same term, which looks like S squared minus omega squared plus 2is omega. Go back over here. Numerator is what it is. So s squared minus omega squared plus 2is omega. For the denominator, be careful here if you wrote it the same way I did because terms are out of order, but we have the real part squared. So that's s squared minus omega squared squared. And then the imaginary parts multiplied together. Negative 2i times 2i is overall positive 4, then s squared omega squared. We are actually not done. We can do a better job with this denominator than what we currently have. And that's because if I take this and expand it, we would get s to the 4th minus 2s squared omega squared. Yeah, minus 2. Sorry, kind of froze for a second because I've got the squares. So minus s squared omega squared is minus 2s squared omega squared plus omega to the fourth. But then when I add 4s squared omega squared to this negative 2s squared omega squared, it would flip this to positive. And then you realize, wait a second, that means that this entire denominator that we're looking at must be s squared plus omega squared squared. So I'm going to write that, and at the same time, I'm going to break this up into real and imaginary components, as you're probably expecting. So we have the real part is going to look like s squared minus omega squared all over. Again, by expanding this and then adding 4s squared omega squared, flipping the sign here, we realize that this should be s squared plus omega squared squared. And then plus I times 2s omega divided by the same denominator. So on the one hand, we took t and we scaled it by the complex exponential, and we've said what the Laplace transform is. But this means we also know the Laplace transform of t times cosine omega t and t times sine omega t. So this, let me do a different color. This first part here, we now conclude, must be what it looks like when you take the Laplace transform of t times cosine omega t, because cosine of omega t is the real part of the complex exponential. And then similarly, the second piece here must be the Laplace transform of t sine of omega t, because sine of omega t is the imaginary part of this complex exponential. Okay, we are now ready to solve the differential equation that we would like to do in this lesson. Let me mention here that these are the kinds of pieces that you see when you encounter resonance like we have in this equation. So that's why I wanted to establish what our standard trig functions look like when scaled by t, because ultimately that's going to come up in our solution for this differential equation. Let's now solve the second order differential equation, y double prime plus 4y equals cosine of 2t, with initial conditions that y of 0 is negative 2 and y prime at 0 is 0. The first thing we're going to do is just take the Laplace transform of both sides, start simplifying and bringing in our initial conditions. These first few steps did not need anything we've done so far in this video. So the first few steps, you just proceed with the Laplace transform. To take the Laplace transform of the left-hand side, I'm going to go ahead and break it up with linearity. So that's the Laplace transform of y double prime plus 4 times the Laplace transform of y. And then on the right-hand side, we need to transform cosine of 2t, which we know how to do. All right. The Laplace transform of y double prime is s squared times the Laplace transform of y minus s times y of 0 minus y prime at 0. Okay, so that's the first expression, and then we're going to add to that 4 times the Laplace transform of y. On the right-hand side, to transform cosine of 2t, it's going to be s divided by s squared plus omega squared. Here is this number 2. So you can write 2 squared, I'm just going to write 4. Great. Let's see, y of 0 is negative 2. Y prime at 0 is just 0, so that whole term gets wiped out. Let's collect like expressions on the left-hand side. Again, it's not a coincidence that I write s squared plus 4 times the Laplace transform of y, where this looks an awful lot like the left-hand side. That's what you would expect. Then we're going to have s over s squared plus 4 on the right-hand side. And then overall, this was positive 2s, so we have to subtract off 2s, like that. Let's isolate the Laplace transform of y now, and then I'll pause to give you a moment to assess what's going on and see what you recognize. So at this point, we can isolate the Laplace transform of y and say that this is s divided by s squared plus 4, that quantity squared. So see if you can recognize that. And then similarly, I'm going to write minus 2 and then s divided by s squared plus 4. Okay, I think you should pause and try to work through both of these on your own. Both of them are versions of what we have here. So either cosine or sine or t cosine or t sine, and for the right choice of omega. So take a moment and see if you can put this in a form that exactly matches what we have over here, and likewise this one, so that we can back out of this expression what the solution y to this differential equation has to be. Okay, let's see how you did. This one, this fraction here, is exactly the Laplace transform of cosine of 2t. And then we have this leading negative 2 in front, so that when we invert this expression, that's going to look like negative 2 times cosine of 2t. Okay, so that one's good to go. For this other one, it looks like either t cosine of 2t or t sine of 2t. Because of the presence of just s up here in the numerator, it looks the most like sine, like t times sine. But if we look at the numerator for t times sine of 2t, we have 2s omega. And here we just have s. We need to make this look like that. So I'm going to do something kind of strange. I'm going to do 2 for the 2. So 2s, and then omega in this case is 2. So 2 times s times 2. I brought in a 4 in the numerator, and that's not really fair if I don't also cancel it out. So let me also bring in a leading 1/4. Hope you can still read this. But I've now taken s, which was a nice simple expression, and rewritten it as 1/4 times 2 times s times 2, so that the 2s2 looks exactly like 2s omega. Now we can say, hey, this is 1/4 times t times sine of 2t, and that's exactly it. We're ready to say what the solution to this differential equation is. It's this 1/4 t sine of 2t minus 2 cosine of 2t. By solving this equation, if I had these formulas here and I just proceeded with the Laplace transform, it never really required me to stop and recognize that resonance was happening, but I still think it's a good exercise to do so. So where do we see the resonance in the solution? We see it here with this t. That's going to cause our solution, this oscillating part here, to oscillate with increasing amplitude as time goes to infinity. I don't want to get off topic, so I just want to mention this really quickly, and that is, if you compare what we just did to getting the solution perhaps using the first way you ever learned how to solve these equations, which would have been characteristic equation and method of undetermined coefficients, this is the homogeneous solution. This is the particular solution. I just want to mention this because we're looking at a situation where we have resonance. Here's the natural motion for this harmonic oscillator, if that's what we're modeling with this differential equation. This is the particular solution, which is the behavior caused by this forcing of cosine 2t on the right-hand side of our differential equation. And because that cosine of 2t is repeating the natural motion of our harmonic oscillator, it's causing resonance. We're reinforcing the oscillation, and that's picking up this t here. Okay, so I hope you stuck with me there through the very end. I just wanted us to look at what happens when you have resonance occurring in this kind of differential equation, and that brought in some new Laplace transforms.